the idea of connecting electromagnetic field science to electrical engineering or circuit theory is a problem, because only two universities that I've been aware of so far try to meet those two subjects together. You know, you might have had to take some fields classes in school, and basically, I think most people remember that it was just a lot of calculus and you were glad it was over. And so when you go into the electrical engineering classes and you start learning circuit theory, it's like, oh, this is a lot easier, I can understand that. But circuit theory falls apart on anything more than DC. So nothing in our world is DC. In fact, as I was saying, the cores of these parts are switching in tens to hundreds of gigahertz. You know, we're working on 14 nanometer parts right now. The switches are moving in femtoseconds. There's a 2 nanometer device, I think, that's been going into production. We're looking at single digit femtosecond transistor switching. So if you aren't afraid of what that kind of switching energy is going to do to your design, then you're not paying attention. And a lot of companies out there today are not paying attention, and they're going out of business because they can't afford this multiple iteration with no hope of return. So hopefully when you leave here today, you're going to have a little better perspective and be a little more likely to be successful in the designs. If you're already successful, then hopefully what I'm going to talk about will reinforce the methods that you're using and give you some confidence to go forward and continue to do that.